Hello, I am Sreekanth Kopuri from Machilipatnam. I am the current poetry editor for Kitchen Sink magazine, New Jersey. I must sincerely thank the organizers of Panorama International Poetry Festival for inviting me as one of the delegates for this most prestigious event. It's indeed a great privilege and honor to associate myself as one. The title of my poem is Trajectory of the Void. My poem is based on the scientific theory of Big Bang and the biblical theory of man's original sin, about which the celebrated epic poet John Milton, in his first book of Paradise Lost, writes like this. I quote, "Of man's first disobedience and fruit of that forbidden tree, whose mortal taste has brought death into the world, and all over all, with the loss of Eden, till one greater man restores and regain the blissful seat." This theory, this scientific theory of Big Bang and biblical theory of man's original sin, cosmologically, both of them, I believe, are same. They approach with a similar objective, but with different perspectives. My poem focuses on the origins of the void and how the spirit of mortality gradually came to establish itself on the earth, the destructive signatures of which we can see from time to time in the events such as in the deadliest events such as the Black Plague, which emerged in 16th century, the First World War, the Second World War, the Holocaust, the Industrial Revolution, which brought with it the pollution into the world as a Gorgonian trajectory, and even till the monstrous pandemic, the COVID-19. So my poem starts with the origins of this void and mortality till date. Here I go. Trajectory of the Void. When the apple tempted my mother's desire, the answer slithered with a knowledge as vengeance, and exploded the Big Bang that severed the cord in the navel beyond. Here a birth cries in death's cradle now, suckled black milk by the breast of a vengeance that is sown in the elemental veins and the pride of nations. It explodes a centrifugal order, maggots displayed still such life under the burnt chambers of Auschwitz and Syrian debris. Our naturally black marrow skins the earth that burns the terminal marrows of the dying flicker in the wind of time. The sun sweats into the dark blue moon, the bones of a lion and the tender petals of a wilted rose are worn by the sharp edge of time's brandished smile. When the waters of our learning trespass with the quest of earthquake, in the trenches of determination, graveyards are adorned by the spiders and ants for the coronation of a revenge against the world that bleeds under the pervading shadows of the void. The hoofbeats of nations pride sink in the sands of the earth's judgment. Thank you very much.